We now move on to our Padma Award winner, I would say, category. I would like to first invite Professor G.D. Yadav, our Vice Chancellor and a Padma Shri Award winner. He has been a senior to Professor Pandit and he has also seen him for a long time. Sir, please share a few words.
At the outset, let me wish a very, very happy birthday to my dear colleague, Professor Anirudh Pandit. Our guru, Professor Sharma, also my guru and colleague, Professor J.B. Joshi, Mrs. Anala Pandit, Professor Smita Lele, Mrs. Joshi, Professor R. Krishna, who is an emeritus professor at the University of Amsterdam and also a longtime colleague and admirer of Professor Pandit, who is incidentally here. Sri J.F. Lashkari, the former president of UDCT Alumni Association. Sri Rajan, R.G. Rajan, who happens to be classmate of Professor Pandit and also a dear friend of mine. I see Mr. S.M. Mukashi sitting there quietly with Mrs. Mukashi and other dignitaries who are present here for this momentous occasion. I am indeed thrilled for Anirudh, not only for what he has achieved over the years, but I have known him from the very first day when he entered ICT, and as Professor Joshi mentioned, he was writing this very celebrated review on mechanically agitated contactor and used to meet Professor Sharma, and I just happened to know him that time. And thereafter he finished his PhD, he was an associate lecturer, went to Cambridge and made fantastic contributions to chemical engineering science. And when I visited, I was in Canada during that time, and I had an opportunity of visiting UK and went to him and Niranjan. They were roommates. I had nice dinner with them. Niranjan's daughter was just born. And I still remember that when I went to University of Manchester, UMIST, had a discussion with Red Man, he said, "Your friend Anirudh Pandit is doing very well." I was very happy to know that although he was just a postdoctoral fellow, he has made a name for himself, and J.F. Davidson used to talk very fondly about him. So that is what, you know, that reputation percolates. And Professor Sharma is a person who identifies future stars. He has that eye. And so, perhaps many of you may not know it, he was instrumental in getting him Scientist B position of UGC, by which is equivalent to a reader's position. Anirudh was, you know, asked to join ICT. He had many offers, but he joined ICT as a reader. And not only that, many of you may not know that you're talking about cavitation, hydrodynamic cavitation. It is Professor Sharma who suggested that he should work on this area because he had read many papers, and he said, "Anirudh, please work and take this area to the next level." And he should be immensely pleased today to know that he has not only taken that area to a greater level, but his students and their students have taken it to a greater level. So this is what is a visionary leader. So I salute Professor Sharma for identifying Professor Pandit as a future star and bringing him to ICT when he could have gone to any IIT, or for that matter any industry, or worked in UK. He had offers from UK, like Niranjan had, and Niranjan stayed there in Reading, but Anirudh came back to, and the rest is history, as they say. But what is most interesting about him, not many of you know that. I know that because I work with my own hands and I do experiments and like to do experiments apart from writing theory. Anirudh is a very good engineer, and he is the person you would take a spanner and go and work on, you know, reactors and whatnot. Many of you perhaps do not know that, but I know that. I'm sure he must have repaired some, you know, cooking vessels or something at the, in the kitchen, and Anala must be witness to that because he is that kind of engineer. So he's a practicing engineer. So that is why no wonder he's looking at the chula these days and trying to find out how to increase the efficiency. And when Professor Joshi, lots of times he talks about his passion for social work and rural areas. Professor Pandit has been mentored by two great giants here. And let us not forget that. Professor M.M. Sharma and Professor J.B. Joshi, who have stood with him all the time in thick and thin to ensure that he is happy. He was given consultation assignments, which he, of course, he made wonders with them, and the industry was very happy to offer him a good amount of money. It's just not, but the professional satisfaction. So if hydrodynamic cavitation has become ICT's brand mark, it is because of him and because of those two gurus which I mentioned just now. But apart from that, something else I must tell you. I've been talking a lot these days. I'm saying we want to be the best institute in the country, maybe some of the best in the world. We will do this, we will do that. Can I do it alone? Answer is simply no. Because of colleague like Professor Pandit, our impact factor is going up, our citation record is going up, and our NAC grading and everything is because of colleague like Professor Pandit. So let us applaud for that, because it is not just one person, but the contribution and the inspiration of the students. And he has inspired so many students. I know that personally, I know that he has helped a lot of these students. He continues to help them. Many of them should be grateful to him, because sometimes, you know, we do that at the middle of the night. Some student sends a message or sends a SMS, sir, tomorrow is the deadline for my for my letter, my recommendation. Really, I was the other day in Chennai, middle of the night, some student sends me, sir, tomorrow is the late, and at 8:30 I had a meeting. So I kept awake till 2 o'clock in the morning. I said, let me finish this job. He has also done the same thing, because the students say that this is how the teacher is inspiring. And I always say that it's not only the teacher who inspires, but the students inspire the teacher more. When a teacher does a good job, the student always comes and says, thank you very much, sir, for, you know, molding my career, doing something for me, helping me when it was needed the most. It's not just getting the job. You know, in our case, we have to not only give the degree to the student, but the nokri and chokri also. So, you know, sometimes references come about the groom and brides. How is this boy? Is he a good boy or a good girl? And we have to give references. So that way, Anirudh and I are related, because his mama's home is Kolhapur. So I am from Kolhapur, so we are related. Not only that, I had a student called Radhika, and he had a student called Jagdish Thambi. They got married, so we were related. So this is how, you know, the teachers and the students, you know. And there is no rivalry, because Radhika once told me she is marrying. I said, hey, very good, now we are related. Because this kind of thing, the love and affection which he has shown to the undergraduate students, you will not find it. No wonder that he won so many awards as a best teacher. And I jokingly said this to many others, that you don't have to attend Anirudh's lectures, Professor Pandit's lecture. You sit in the garden and just start taking down the notes. His voice comes out, you capture it, or keep your mobile phone on and record it. You don't have to worry. Even if you don't attend the class, you will know what he is speaking. His diction is so loud and clear that even, you know, the one of his students just now said, you know, what is his name? Shankar. Shankar said that he inspired, he came from Jalgaon and inspired. No wonder he has inspired him, because there are many other students who have told me very passionately how, you know, Professor Pandit has been instrumental in shaping their career, and that is the most satisfying factor. ICT has been built by generation of teachers, and some of them are remembered forever. He will be one of them, because he has definitely contributed to the growth and the glamour and glitter of ICT, and I'm immensely pleased for him as a colleague and as my friend. It's not that, you know, normally when you sit in the big chair, you know, Professor Joshi always said with affection, Yogesh, Are kasa ahes tu? Anirudh is the only other person who calls me Are Ture, nobody else does it. Because he is so close to me as a friend, and we have maintained that friendship over the years. And I take him as a great person, not only for his intellectual contributions, but human aspects. His hydrodynamic cavitation, we took to Kolhapur, we are dancing with joy, we say Rankala is clean. And it is because of him, not because of me, I must have done something, but it is because of him. That program has become successful and will continue to do that. So I think the gathering here has shown why he is so much revered, why he is liked by everybody. And right from his school days, I did not know about this Pushkara Chauhan until a few minutes ago. He made a very passionate, very nice speech in Marathi, very good speech. You know, sometimes your colleagues, your students, your acquaintances, relatives tell you about the person, and the person, then you try to project that person and then say, oh, I knew him, but I did not know this aspect of this person. So today we came to know many things about Professor Pandit, and I'm so happy that I'm present today, because Parag asked me last 2 days, I was out of station, but he asked me whether I'm there. I said, Are, why have you chosen 23rd? Because it's a long weekend, whether people will be there. And he said, no, sir, this is a nice time. I said, I'll definitely be there. I would like to be there. Even if he had not invited, I would have come as a right, because he is my colleague and we are proud of him. Ladies and gentlemen, they always say in Sanskrit, Jiveta Sharadashatam, live 100 years. He's already with his gray beard, he looks like a sage, he looks like a Rishi Muni. So he should grow. Sages grew, they lived up to 1,000 years. You know that our Puran and our scriptures and mythology always said these Rishis lived 1,000 years, and they went on giving knowledge, new knowledge. It's not just the old knowledge, new knowledge. And no wonder that, he has been so revered. Wherever I go, I also hear many things about my colleagues. He is one of them, mentioned by, no matter which chemical engineering department you go in the country or abroad, Professor Pandit is known to them. And that is what his contribution. And I'm so happy for him that, and also Anala. Because, good that Anala got a nice match, and Anala Kulkarni became Anala Pandit. I wish their daughter was here, because I knew little Spurthi. Now, Anirudh is not only well-known in UK, now he has become well-known in USA. He got an American son-in-law. It's a great thing, So let us, also, see that, he goes beyond these boundaries of India. In terms of his knowledge, contributions to chemical engineering, because he has served our profession. These days, chemical engineers are not looked at favorably by others. The society thinks these guys are, computer engineers are preferred over chemical engineers. The girls also think that chemical engineer is not worth as a husband, but somebody else. But those who have married chemical engineers will always say that they are very good husbands. So I'm sure that this celebration continues, and I can assure you that what he has started for the undergraduate students, through the endowment, we welcome that. We require those kind of things, because we care a lot. And also I want to tell you, our alumni association, he was the president of the alumni association for 4 years. And during that time, I said everybody who joins ICT should be a member of Alumni Association. He supported our board, passed that resolution. That is how Alumni Association has grown, and that is how Alumni Association helps us. And we should be proud of Alumni Association. Dilip Udas, you don't worry that Professor Pandit was not only president for 4 years, but I know that he has many contributions to Alumni Association. So on behalf of all my colleagues in ICT, on behalf of all of you, on behalf of all my family members, they know him so very well. I wish him all the best in his life, and may he live beyond 100 years. May he continue to teach and always win the prizes, because now retirement is not 65, 70. I'm saying let it go to 75, because 70, it is all possible, because it is, retirement is in your mind. I don't think professors like Professor Sharma and Professor Joshi are retired. They are beating their younger colleagues or younger students in their knowledge by their contribution. I also believe the same about Professor Pandit. He will continue to create new knowledge, create new technology, and help society at large and the nation at large. And I'm sure the ICT's future will be great with people like Professor Pandit. Thank you very much.